We are back. Part three, helping Tom and Rachel with their council enforcement notice. First up, we're tackling this hedge. We're going to get it down to about shoulder height. It's grown out of control, probably about 3 or 4 foot higher than it should be. Over this side, it's a bit more prickly. We've got brambles all over the place, and we're going to try and pull them out and just reduce it so you don't get snagged on them. And if you haven't seen, we have got a nice mossy wall and a grimy drive right here. So we'll be getting the pressure washer out and get these colours popping. Unfortunately, that is not going to be in this episode. He's still on holiday. But he's back next week for Helping Barbara, part one, which I'm excited about and nervous. Anyways, you know the drill. Time to stop waffling and let's get cracking. So we spoke to the neighbour next door. He generally keeps this side trimmed anyway, which is great, but we'll use this for access to get the height down, which he's happy about. Yeah. Oh, look. The litter bugs are out again. Thank you. Right, that is the hedge trimmed, this bit tidied up, and the driveway is now ready for pressure washing. Must be a good 3 or 4 videos since I've done some pressure washing, so excited to get stuck in. And it's only concrete, but it will make such a difference. I've only got 500 litres, I think, in the tank in the van. They've got no outside tap, so we might have to leave these walls green. They weren't bothered, but yeah, we'll see how much water we got. Let's get going.
Been a while.
Tom, without coming out and without having a peek,
you know along the driveway, there's the mossy walls?
Yeah.
Keep or go?
If you can get rid of it, yeah.
Yeah, but I can pressure wash it off. It's just some people like the moss, some people don't. So I just wanted to make sure what sort of person you was.
No, that'd be fine.
Moss is gone, yeah? All right, I'll get on that now.
Yeah.
All right, mate, I'll come get in a bit. Cheers, mate. You ready?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh my God.
I haven't seen it look like that since we first moved in here. And that was, how long ago?
2006.
Oh, wicked.
So when we first moved in, you used to trim the bush, didn't you?
Because yeah.
That's before you got sick.
That is amazing.
Yeah, I think it's popped in your face, if you know what I mean. We've got that down to height, that'll go green spring, yeah. And then, yeah, all this is just... Yeah. Can be used as an exit now rather than.
Yeah.
Because it was how slippery it must have been.
Wow.
But yeah.
I'm stunned. That is really amazing.
Good. I told you I want to just go above and beyond. I want to I try and wow people. Light and bright is for you. Then I'm like, I don't know, that gives me a buzz when I look at that and just sort of think it lifts your mood. It lifts your mood with the brightness rather than the dull and dingy don't do it for me. So, like.
I'm just amazed at how it looks. It's absolutely brilliant.
Oh, wicked.
Yeah. Youngest when he was little, he used to get in under his bed. Him and his friends used to get in under here, and they used to come
you'd love it, wouldn't you?
Muddy and dirty. And
yeah. And there we go. I think we've absolutely smashed it. So this is the first time I've actually shaped something rather than rip it out, and I feel like I've done a good job, but let me know if you've done it differently or how the way to do it. Tom wanted the mossy walls gone, so they have been blasted. I think they've come up really nice. Concrete's popped too. We've got 4 bags left to get rid of. And, well, I think we've pretty much done everything now to comply with the council enforcement notice, but we're going to come back for part four because around the corner there's some brambles to tackle and some more slippery paths. So stay tuned for that, subscribe, join the journey. Yeah, I'm going to stop waffling and see the family outro. Cheers.
What's this?
I'm watching.
What's this?
I'm watching.